It's the same as what you're doing now.
Yes.
So, so the idea is just that you shout out your ideas and you discuss them. And sorry about the recording. Anybody watching, it's more of a discussion thing. Don't have multiple microphones. And basically, only Philippe provided some ideas beforehand, so he is in the advantage of actually every class. If we have nothing to discuss anymore, then keep going and have something fun.
Or we can tool.
Or we can keep going, yeah. This is actually one of my.
That's a good point.
So we are actually dead lean hackers. Anybody from Intel here? No? Sorry that you submitted a plan. We really should reply to it. It looked like a basic.
Yeah.
It's just. I always get lost in what you call the therapist.
It's so big.
It's so big.
I would actually be happy to have a mental event without wanting to reply to that text. I don't want to do it myself. It's just insane vector crap. It's obviously important that it's done, and it's good that they're offering assistance, so, yes.
Yes.
And it's not going to go away,
either. You will reply to them and tell them what they should target for September.
They should start mapping and what then. You remember how long all the power is, the recent round of power, whatever it's called now, power 5, or power 17, or whatever it is.
So, what do people want? Shout out ideas first, do some slides, then shout ideas, tell everybody what to talk about, anything.
I would say it would be important to talk about sort of issues of stuff we need to do and things.
So, what do we need to do?
Well, remove dark jeans.
Beautiful.
Actually, that is one of them. There.
Oh yeah, so we need to new part of the X. Is there any objections? I mean, the thing is more dead than something that's very dead. So, we've made extensive efforts, so you have to, two of you have, right, to try and contact them, there's no...
So, we put it through a copy of Kit Lou. Yay! The follow-up question is more. Yeah, it would be really nice to have an IC build. Currently, we are missing an IC build for ARM 32. So maybe we should do that. Now that actually seems to be good, so it would be nice to have it.
I think more mandatory is than an IC build to maintain it.
Yeah.
It's a problem.
I don't know anything about the previous course.
I keep thinking it would die off and go away, but it's kind of so uncharitable.
Would be nice to integrate it, but I don't know.
I think in the past.
Maybe they just can't. They just can't because they have to put some effort and maintain the board.
But you maintain
partially, no? So, I think it's sort of sketchy. Or when they do it now, and then maybe several others.
Do you think you should bring it?
No, not any board.
So, for the smart board, do you have any yet?
Smart board is not ready yet because we have some design problems. We would need to extend somehow the beds and corporate infrastructure first. And then, when we are ready, we will ask for estimate for sure.
No, but I know it's actually a bit hard these days to get the permit access spot. You don't happen to have one?
I have to ask.
Or sales department.
Okay, sorry.
I know there are some smart machines in the bottom of the middle that are public accessible. You can, the company provides some access to machines, but the interface is already, it's not possible to SSH in. You've got some kind of credit code or whatever, it's not available. So I have to ask what happens to the people.
Sorry.
But GPT people somehow do the tests on the file, and they got some access to the file, so maybe that would be
a... Oh, maybe we can ask. I don't know. I have to admit that Sweden's basis grows on you after a while. But yeah, it's...
These things, I think, are pretty well expected.
Yeah.
But otherwise, for example, the function called styles, you find each of everything. When I'm writing code, I'm always losing a little bit of time thinking, what style should I use? I'm doing a lot less in GDB, but then there's no question.
Yeah. And, I'm not that bothered, but I really would like the D8 character line, because why the English needs a screen space. And I really want to change the video version at the time.
We are the
giant emerging process group. But we've also got a giant history problem. Other stuff like function calls. No.
I answered that I don't know what is. What is this?
Yeah, but you're assuming that there's actually, somebody's actually thought about this and they're not sure. I don't think it's. That's a wrong assumption.
Okay. When I was in making a whole bunch of changes, I saw mostly both the first one and the third function call style. Name space, paren space, arg space, paren. I tried to make it completely possible.
That's a solid. What first style did you work on?
That's all three of those.
You might have drifted over the years as well.
But I don't see any more. I don't like to do the last one. But if you could say, if you write in code, write this word.
What Goon does, I know, is that they have a style checker that must pass on any new code that gets added to the trunk. So all the bad code from previous authors, it's fine. If you ever touch that, you have to update it. But if you're adding new code, touch old code, you've got to get fixed in the style.
That's actually a reasonable approach, if anybody can be willing to actually implement that. Can I add an item to the agenda?
Well, yeah, sure.
One is, say, you and I just went to say, anyway, should we merge Vex repo back into Valkyrie? It's kind of a pain in the ass having two different repos.
Yes, we really should.
Hang on, we have... Yeah, that's...
Okay, I'm fixing stuff up.
Yeah, that's the only question. I actually don't like the name Git because it seems sounds unfriendly. I'm so used to using Mercurial, but I can kind of see the way the wind is blowing on it. So, it's not in Mercurial's favor.
Yeah, so to be honest, I'm only a bit bothered by the split of the lip effects and all that, because I already have a version to get the values, but we have some credit, so I can actually do quick culture history search and so on.
So if we move to Git, then somebody would have to do conversion.
We have your sources.
Oh yes, okay. And then we need to have the Git master repo living somewhere, right?
Yes. Yeah. So that's one of the possibilities. For example, sort of that. Yeah. They would go to the most popular.
Software
platform, like the other GDB, Exadeos, QC, Amostita. So if you invite to some of that, that would be it.
That's interesting, okay. Would anybody have a problem in principle if we moved away from subversion? I actually don't like having a single point of failure of the repo. I pack it up every couple of weeks, but so, I don't like that.
So where is it hosted now?
It's hosted by a Cambridge-based company called Mythic Beasts, which sounds ludicrous, but they're quite a good company. I guess they have places in Cambridge and in London or something like this.
Okay, but who pays? So the idea is just somebody should do it.
Yes.
Yes, and then
so we will do it because we have, for example, done the due diligence for the subversion for you. We can do that for the rest of the knowledge experience.
So you can do that without losing all the history, right?
Yes.
Yeah, so the only problem I see is, do we want to merge the two modules into one Git? Then I don't know how to order this.
Well, I mean, from my point of view, it's a pain in the ass because you have two separate sets of numbers to deal with, and you have to think, is it this tree or that tree, or do I have to commit for both trees since I've actually changed both trees or what? So you want a way that you can actually have just make by itself without having all the other junk wrapped around it.
And I can actually speak to the organizational nightmares of having separate code trees. So all of the modules you talked about, they're all separate trees. They're all separate packages. And to some extent, this has benefited us a lot. Because like people are using Clarifying, Clay, and PyBex just by themselves in lots of good applications. So in some ways it's a nightmare, and in some ways it's very beneficial, and it's really hard to see what it means.
So are you able to say what it will be actually for?
I think in this case, I don't think it would be too much of a nightmare to have them be in the same tree, as long as you just had a make libvex command in the root make file that would just spit out the libraries.
So one of the issues is the test cases.
Yes.
Test cases, they often need felt like this. That's the big reason I would like one, because now we have to find the two commits for the test case.
Yes, okay, I understand. Yeah, I mean, it's just the least true that extra work in the whole business.
Just use it. You can. Let it go away.
Yes.
Yeah, The only other part probably is we have one maintainer that probably has a doing releases based on all this subversion knowledge.
Yeah.
Would you cry much if we move to Git?
Not really. I mean, subversion's been great in the CVS, if you remember those bad days. Mm-hmm. But I can see that it's maybe time to move on and give more modern access to the problem. I don't know how you used it. I don't know how you use the material, but I assume the concept's kind of carried out.
Yeah. It's okay. Let me just do it. See what we also can do
in this house. It's a long way in the future. Well, if we're going to do that, I'd like to do it in the next couple of months. It's moving, first of the sanity check, is moving it to get a reasonably future-proof plan. If we move to Git, is there something else that we're going to have to do in another year? Is that a year from now, or does that seem important?
I don't know. I think the conversion will take some time, especially if you want to make it one big Git repository with all the access in depth. Maybe both history of that might then affect the one. So once the conversion is done, I think it will take some time. So it kind of depends on the person doing the conversion.
Of course, there is also documentation, even there, there's the aircons, the website.
And also, like the
website.
Yeah, the website, how was it called the website? Because the website is very good, it's a very good. And if you connect anything, it's updated.
Yeah,
Yes. So if you push, is that the right word? Push through it with Git and it's automatically updated.
I don't know, I have to investigate what the because they depend on the origin.
Parallel with one channeling the other, and then at some point we switch, or we would just say Friday we stop and Monday morning we use a new one,
yeah,
or something like that. So probably we need a plan or a suggestion about how to do all that, list all the things which have to be done, discuss this a little bit, and then we can go on.
This station approach would be.
Yes,
open parallel for some time.
I'm certainly one of them. We'll figure something out.
To make more to geek out instead of the source, you know, in the end.
So far.
Yeah, to make more to geek out is that using names and such. Geek out is commonly used and all the end is going to geek out.
What we'll be able to do is get GitHub or you can accept pull requests just right there, and you can also put in CI things. There's some little things that we've benefited from in our development.
Because including on GitHub has no bearing on the actual ownership of the code or anything like this, right?
Yeah, I mean, I don't know. Personally, I don't like GitHub. First, because the directors there are on some central. Except for an actual repository, which is all proprietary. So if we can avoid GitHub, find all of
them. Yeah, I'm more inclined towards software, but who's software operating on?
People. But they're nice people. I migrated a project to there. It's kind of funny because it used to be the Cygnus people.
Yeah.
And then they merged with Red Hat, and now all of the people that maintain source are not for Red Hat anymore. I think Red Hat's the base for the hardware that says you maintain it.
Yeah, we didn't have to decide on that.
No, that's a nice thing about it. It's everywhere.
Well, that's a good idea.
Yeah.
So? Well, okay. Well, one of the top level things should be discussed.
Top level things. Let's see what. That's why
we have a project management, really.
This is really project management. So maybe the licensing question would be an interesting top level.
Sure.
Sure. So, yeah, I think we won't take the business. No, just practically because we have to contact everybody. Most people like the GPL, but it's high bias.
Right. You are only asking to a binary exception. So it's, you suggest to keep GPL, but add the binary exception.
I mean, it's a little unusual for there for libraries to be GPL. Usually you GPL end your programs and you stick libraries in the BSD or MIT or something.
Or so what is it you actually want to have happen?
Man, I'm not a lawyer, nor do I even have to be a lawyer.
Yeah, I'm not a lawyer, so just tell me what you want to have happen anyway.
I would like to know whether the library exception would actually make all the people scared about using Angry for commercial activities less scared.
Well, what's the library exception?
I don't even understand that. I just know that it means that libc is LGPL, but you can link against it to not be GPL.
Yeah, well,
just linking does not make your program GPL. You still have to change this. You still have to provide changes to the people using the library. But they can hide things on top of the library, so it becomes a GPL.
Yes. Oh, that library extension. Okay, so there's something here. So realistically, I don't think it's very likely to licensing you change even if you wanted to, because what you have is that the licensing is GPLs as well. And I mean, and that includes idea, Yeah, helping. Yeah. Oracle.
That's a long time.
Yeah, there's some credits written by Paul Neal that was written by Samsung.
So would you need to choose?
It would be invisible to basically not have some kind of work to hack up again all these communicators with English native licensing. So, you know, you need to find out with the licensing exception. You know, basically you go and kick lawyers at your end and find out if that is okay to you. Mm-hmm. And also think about ways that you should work around it. Like, you know, put the separate process or something.
Yes, so a lot of really weird ideas for how to firewall ourselves in the GPL. So our current approach is we have a C part of PyVex, which Stefu interlibvex and sort of provides a nicer interface than Vex Translate Arcs. And so that's GPL, so it's pretty common to the Stefu against GPL for the next GPL. But then we've got PyVex itself is sort of becoming this abstract idea of something that can service requests for IR. And then one of the things that it knows how to call out to is the Vex, the translation, and there's this translation between the libvex structs, which under some interpretations are GPL, and then the PyVex classes, which are imitations of these, but how much intellectual nonsense got copied from one to the other and it's lawyers.
Yes, right. So I would say two things. Firstly, I think it's a problem you guys can solve the art. And secondly, I don't think this is a new problem. Like, I'm sure this movie has also been played 100 times, you know, with the social community in the last few years. So I think you can talk to some FSF people. Well, some FSF people as well. But I probably have had FSF people in the past that have been quite helpful.
There's even a whole network about legal issues. Lots of people would love this kind of
thing. Is there an FSF Europe desk here or something like
this? Yeah, probably there's they also have this desk.
Yeah, I mean,
so, but I think what you kind of one need is a way to have the IR as data and then have different programs manipulate the data, and those different programs are not part of facts and so on. So maybe it's also just structuring the programs and come up with a data representation. But I don't know what it is. I would just give lots of nice programs and benches.
For the past you presented, we've seen mostly other controversial and maybe actually interesting answers mostly. Were you happy to put up the license on the GPL?
Yes. I mean, you need to go through, it's not all my code. It's like me, Fish, Young,
essence somewhere where everybody is what the assets are will be fine. Also, the justice would kind of collect money for the but you could also put copy RPS or the domain name or.
I kind of actually would like to be able to speak to myself under some umbrella organization like that. Felt the lack of that. And I think QA needed that recently, isn't it?
Yeah, that part of the. If you know somebody from but there are more organizations like that. It would be nice because I know they also know this people stuff, so then you can ask them as a member of the project. We have legal stuff. There's at least somebody kind of responsible for answering.
Like to understand the legal implications, maybe something like that would be. So. From a technical point of view, this is a totally different question. As far as release changes go, do we want to stick with what we have or do something different? Or do we need to do a 3.12.1 release?
I think it would be nice, although. At least for Fedora and RHEL, I cherry pick a lot, but I know other distributions don't, so it would really be good for the distributions because like I have this Tubuntu for example. They needed a bit, but there was the release, so it took half a year for the what's the red room number? Yeah, it was a two-line patch.
Yes, yeah, Steve's patch, yeah.
Yeah, but as soon as there was a release, they pulled in the release. So I think it's nice to have one, two releases.
So you're saying you think you should do 3.12.1
of this? Yeah, that would be nice. But it's also
working.
Yeah. But I think ideally we have a yearly release and then one or maybe two or three releases.
Yes. Well, I could try and assemble a 3.12.1 release and have to do that. Do maybe one and a half days a week on Valgrim. No, I'll try and deal with the Intel people because it's really, that needs to be done, but it should come through.
Yeah.
I would have to look at your patches. You have to look at the git situation. Firefox above a lot, and if you learn, and you get some really bad
saving the mechanisms is bad, but it was significantly faster years ago, and I don't think this is the case anymore. So my suggestion is to switch to try. Try means if the ticket scheduler, ticket clock works, use it, otherwise automatically fall back to the pipe scheduler.
I'm a bit nervous about that, if you really mean testing dynamics at startup, because...
No, I don't think so. If it's configured in...
Right.
I don't think it's dynamic.
So couldn't we just configure it so that it's set to yes on Linux and no on macOS? Well, anyway, so this is a micro discussion, yes, but we could... I think we should change it. Can I ask a different question?
Yeah.
What should we do about macOS core? It's kind of sort of kind of worked some time ago. I made it kind of working less and less. I no longer have time to fix it, and I feel bad just leaving it, so I'm not sure what to do.
There was someone really active, which seems to be
risky.
A little bit active. Yes, it's risky. High speed or I don't know.
It's very good.
So, as far as I know, he's still improving and fixing things. And like, he has fixed things for more centuries on macOS. So, but I don't never use. It's 5 years or so, so I don't know the state.
So maybe after COVID, from others looking for effort, or maybe doing it before.
No, you don't like this stuff that I don't know if you can get
it. I feel like there's making notes.
Yes, I really, in fact, I take a note about what I would like to see. But I see we have evolved that we were from the Git stuff. Then we have to see to change the default value of per step in try or yes. Julien, you said that you would contact the AVX by 12 Intel people. The FreeBSD, I'm not sure if we try or not to integrate them.
It's going to be quite a lot of work.
It's actually have to see if you just state then work and people work on the stuff of the VIP, but we see, for example, we see both of the people and
so maybe we should contact them.
Yeah. Do we close them?
Well, we can find them. Right? We can find them. I can find them.
So you
have a lot of contact in this
system. Okay.
I also would be happy to do 3.12.1 release, coordinate that.
That's all good, a lot of actions and I'm getting the way.
Maybe we can do a round and what's your thoughts?
Well,
sorry.
Combination.
Yeah, you want to do it, but the capacity of the picture.
Yeah.
Oh, sorry.
No, MacOS, it doesn't bother me. Yeah, I don't use it.
I kind of feel somehow bad that we ship in code which kind of doesn't really work well enough to run large programs on MacOS.
Yeah.
And you know, we're damaging our reputation by shipping a thing that's not that great.
Yeah.
I just don't know.
It doesn't work anyway.
Well, it could just about run Firefox on the, you know, if you put the computer down build kind of thing a few releases back, and now I'm pretty sure it works.
Yeah.
If you have a window behind it, so.
Yeah, I'm not sure. We're probably just at the last week's or twice in how he feels.
I used it for 4 weeks ago when I for Singapore versions of GPT-4, and the GPT-4 was okay. I ignored all the problems.
This kind of freaks me for you. You had better information compiled with Microsoft Visual C or don't get global compiler or something.
That is the normal compiler.
I mean, you try to use NGW and Sigma, and it tries to link in a bunch of random crap. Like, how well do I do this?
I mean, I understand the culture shock, but it's easier to be native.
Okay, I don't know, I've never used it, but it's
yeah, really... It was quite some CV, but quite some 1 to 2 years ago to make a new Windows port for my
media,
which started to work.
Oh, really?
Yes, and then it's
that?
Disappeared in the black hole.
Oh, that's completely
changed. If you don't know Windows, it's really a fun environment to work. So if anybody wants to take it as a project, you know, to try out, that would be actually kind of cool.
Maybe you should just point it.
Yeah, you guys are back there.
Can you get rid of the AIDS patient?
You've also made some effort on parallelization as well.
I'm not volunteering, Philippe.
No, I'm not volunteering either, but I just pointed this as and it would be an architectural cleanup, a structural cleanup that would be really cool to do if you can do it without losing performance. So
I guess I can toss into the top of the line is the making best thread safe project.
So you basically means having a bunch of thread local state or TLS. I don't even really know what it means. I know what that means. So what does it entail? What do you should do?
And the way I envision it is just you end up having a method that you have initialized that the callback that is give me my thread local storage block, and there is just a top level libvex local storage block struct, which is the user knows that it must allocate a block of that size and have a separate one for each thread and confirm the best.
So that sounds harmless, but I would ask you, how would you actually enforce this? So 2 years down the line, somebody who's not really aware of this mechanism has a global variable in VEX and all becomes uncertain thread safe again. Is there some automatic way we can avoid it?
To self-host login under a game and then it would report.
Can you describe us, please? Isn't there some flag in GCC that says there's an island global variable?
You need at least one global variable for the federal storage callback. But other than that, but given that you probably just go and write a simple script which takes libvex.so and says, are there any global variables other than this means by this way?
Cool.
Performance. So when things example, today when we access
so one of the things that I was thinking is, if this is a real performance secure concern, you want to be able to run the best single thread environments as fast as you could, it could also just be a pre-processor flag that, so all the accesses to the global can go through a macro, which can be single thread version, which evaluates to a global, this is the struct, which is a single global variable, but on multi-thread version, it would go into the callback and get back a point into the variable.
For the moment, because the rest of my units effectively see the credit, it's just the cost and no benefit for parking. Mm-hmm. So maybe a compilation option of VEX.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I don't like multiple compilation options, which means you have multiple programs you have to validate. But I mean, maybe it's not expensive, because how many global suspects would you
have? A lot. I actually tried doing this to see if I could do a quick thing and include it in my hashtag. There's so many. But on top of that, there's also the allocation mechanism.
That has to be threaded.
Yeah.
Every thread, like you say, has to have this 5 megabyte buffer or whatever it is.
I mean, you could just stick that in the block, but I'll just be stuck in the block, I guess. I mean, I need to evaluate like what the actual performance of Dex's memory allocation looks like and what it would look like to add, for example, more callbacks for how the client program would specify, I'm doing your memory management now.
Oh, that's definitely a big problem. Yeah. Is it allocated like, or is it, I'm just doing that fashion?
Yeah, this is something that I could take on as a side project at some point down the road. Yeah, I mean, looking at the feasibility. I don't know. It's given that there seems to be some degree of support, given that you can show that it's not detrimental to performance, that makes me confident enough to try to throw in some weight into it.
I think it will be detrimental to performance, though, because now I think it's called a lot. It's in mind, and it's like a construction.
I think it's definitely possible for there to be a compile flag that just says this is single threaded only now, and we're going to make all of our have one version of the TLS struct that's just in global memory.
Master list of all this stuff.
I have given some rules.
That's
marginal. That means big things.
Chopped out the version part. Then you can
What is the version of the result?
they can say. But if they point to other blocks, then the results are identified anyway, because the calculator could point the blocks.
You say the result is undefined as if this doesn't happen all the time.
So either action which is to be the thesis of which okay.
So does everybody have a thought now? So I think you two said yes. Anybody?
Yeah, actually, yes. Just one question. I think related to this, what is the status of the Xen support, and if there is interest or not? Because Valgrind supports symbols for DOM CTLs and CTLs, right, of Xen, but it supports until Xen 4.5, if I'm not mistaken, right?
No,
there is
some
support for
extend system calls.
Yes, for CTLs.
Yeah, and yeah, I of course.
There's some support in Valgrind, but it's until Xen 4.5. I'm asking this because I created a patch for Xen 4.6 and started on Xen 4.7.
Yeah.
I don't know if there is any interest or...
So you assume that there's management, but there's no management. We just got... People used to send us Xen patches and sometimes we'd merge them. And I had no idea, I had no idea what they did, but they didn't break the compile, so they went in.
Yes, there's interest as long as it doesn't work.
That's right.
You
mean who wrote them or?
No, who committed them?
Oh, I don't know. Me or Tom. They came from a guy called Ian Campbell, is that right?
He's the F R C.
Your patches are either back on this year?
No. So I am sending to a small, it's just a minor correction for example for Porsche's file. I noticed that there are some DOM CTLs, also there's another patch from someone else. And I have patches that apply on top of the
you have introduced a bug in Bugzilla to follow these patches?
No.
But we can also base
to publish this for the pocket.
Yes, and then both on the developer says your patches please
please integrate this, and I promise I will be the Xen maintainer for the rest of my life, and my children up to the 12 generations or something like that.
There are two in the field, and my employment is open.
So there's answer on the individual, there are more chances to do stuff like that.
Are you still happy to do the mix maintainer?
Yeah.
You're looking kind of unhappy.
No, just following the and I'm just afraid that I don't get something inside the loop. I don't care any feedback with the version, but I'm fine.
Okay, that's good.
So, anybody else got matches that they think the project doesn't like because they're just not communicating?
Yes, that's a good question.
So, because if you have just yellow powder,
yeah.
You don't get a whole lot of people, I think. Okay, are you wearing people out?
Maybe we run out of things.
Yeah.
What do you guys want to do? Touch.
Oh, yes. I have to tell you honestly, I'm not happy with this.
I have decided to copy small WC.
I think it's a different correctness problem than the correctness problem you see.
Yeah, okay.
Which I can summarize by saying, imagine if you have a long sequence of a long basic block. We want to see what the structure is. And the first half came from one line of source code, and the next half came from a different line of source code.
But we have a line of source code. We have the source code.
Well, that's the problem. So if you unwind from basic block starting from some place at the start of the basic block, you can have your snapshots. And the program kind of goes past this invisible transition. And
but it was kind of funny, conservation lifestyle. Nobody. So maybe I'm bad at showing what easy tasks are, or that's not the way to involve people. Probably we need
community manager.
Yeah, community manager. So.
Architectures, but all basically the same.
Yes.
like you will be fine. So you involve the factor lines, and when this price becomes a lot of which depends on my opinion. So why for example,
socket is terrible. It looks differently on the list of everyone.
I factorize these rules. I factorize the fork enemy, which was completely different than what, by the way, what is my question about the needs removal, because I have not yet any replies to similar questions. So, but yes, it's nice to factorize So, yes, if you have patch of factorized code, it is called.
I will take a look. It was basically what it was like when I looked, there was. But it was merged like MIPS 32-64 can the it was like MIPS 64 can the code for 32-bit one or vice versa.
Yeah, there are a lot of